Deuteronomy says in chapter 8:18, says, I give you the power to get wealth. I don't give you the wealth. It's not called show play, show dancing or whatever. It's called show business. Jesus loves us so much, he's going to prepare us. So that journey that you're on is not there to frustrate you, it's there to prepare you.
Yeah, without naming names or networks or shows, give me a horror story. It's interesting because, you know, your work, and it's not only are you a good, you know, animator, not only a good, you don't only draw well, but you're funny, you know, there's humor behind all these things. The way you do your videos, it engages, you know, so many different broad classifications of people. So when I'm seeing somebody that's been in the game for 20, 30 years, mm-hmm. you know, and especially in this world today, you know, what is your opinion? Because so many people today, because of social media, because of they see a success story like your work, and they want success right away. They have an instant gratification type of mentality. Mm-hmm. What's your opinion? What's your reaction to them when they say, "Man, Butch, you know, I want this in my life right away. I want instant success. I'm not getting it in the last 1, 2, 3 years. What's my problem?"
And see, the world, our mindset, we want to get in there and just do it right away and just start. Normally that way lies madness. That's the part where you're going to get hurt because you're not ready for it, you know, and our God loves us. Jesus loves us so much. He's going to prepare us. So that journey that you're on is not there to frustrate you. It's there to prepare you. And so the journey that you're on right now, if you're 20, 30 years old, listen to this, and you want to get in the animation industry, all the work you're doing now, all the connections you're making, they're going to amount to something eventually. Don't ever look on your experience as a bad experience, because it's only an experience. It's a learning
process. It's a journey.
Totally a journey.
It's a journey.
And I always say this, things that affect you instantly aren't really good for you. Drugs, things like that, that happen instantly to you, they're not good for you. It's going to the gym. It's building up your body. It's you can't lift 100 pounds when you first walk into the gym. You got to lift 5 pounds, 20 pounds. And then you're going to get to the point you can lift more. You know, you can't run a TV show until you've worked on a TV show. You need to know how things work. You need to know how to get, how to manage people and how to be a boss. When I got my first cartoon show, I was blessed. It's a blessing. I was so excited, but I had been in the industry for almost 20 years at that time. Then I got a show. And by that point, I knew how to run a show. I could do every piece of the show on my own. That's when I was finally able to get it, when I was ready for it. You know, George Burns has a great quote. He says, "What you're ready for usually shows up." And being ready for something is imperative.
You know, and let's face it, you know, this business is really based a lot on reputation. Mm. And so when you've come into something like that too soon, that could be a very big detriment to your reputation.
Yeah. And
so
if you're not ready for it and you blow it at an early age, it's very hard to dig yourself out of that, which is why I caution people, prepare, get ready, learn. And that's the key.
Right? Well, and think about it. Studios are investing in the person. Mm-hmm. Right. And so if that person isn't ready yet, you know, that could be a big problem. But what we always tell people to do is start on YouTube, start building some of your, whether you want to be on camera or you want to create, mm-hmm. start doing something like that. YouTube, TikTok, get used to putting yourself out there, because that in itself sometimes can be kind of scary when you're putting your heart, your work out into the public, where people can actually tear it apart.
You know, right. And I wrote a book called Mad Hustle. And should I plug the book? Like, I got the
you
book.
You did. Right? Do you have it right next to you?
Do I happen to have the book right next to me?
Wait, no way. No.
That's my book. But anyway, no, my book is called Mad Hustle, and it's all about how to pitch and sell shows in Hollywood.
Oh, perfect.
And the reason I wrote it, I get this question all the time. How do I pitch a show? What do I do? And this book is all about the mistakes and the pitfalls I went through, so you won't have to go through them. And one of the first things I talk about is preparation, number one. And one thing I talk about that people really are blown away, I talk about is partnerships and contracts. And when you're working with other people, how imperative it is to have a written agreement between the two of you. Because when money starts showing up, friendships change very, very quickly. Wow. And it's like, you better have an agreement. Well, it's my brother. He would never be mean to me. Let me tell you something. When a check shows up and you're going to divide it, you got to have an understanding of who is going to get what and how, you know, if creating a show, especially, it's a very tricky thing because.
Especially when someone says, you know, well, I'll just draw your, you know, some of your
characters
or something. And you think, oh my gosh, that's so sweet of you. He wants to help me out. Well, now the show gets picked up by Fox. That guy's coming with his hand out going, where's my money?
Oh, no, he's also going, I get part of the show.
Right.
I drew those drawings because you wouldn't, you know, if you don't pay somebody up front, they can then lay claim to your product.
And have so it's, a contract.
Yeah, we want people to be very, very cautious as to how they go about this. So it's not just about drawing cartoons. There's a whole business side to it too.
And we've seen it all. Unfortunately, we get a lot of people, well, we experienced it, but also we get a lot of people coming to us and saying, why didn't I do a contract? I can't believe that's right.
Yeah.
You know, we do contracts for everything.
Without naming names or networks or shows, give me a horror story. Give me a what's a horror
story? I have a story. I do have a story. It was an early story. It happened to be very early in my career. And
Hanna-Barbera or?
I was in Hanna-Barbera. Yep. Yep. And I'm with them. And Hanna-Barbera was actually taking pitches. We were going to pitch a show. And a friend of mine had an idea. It was a really good idea. He asked me to come and help him develop the idea. So I did. And we worked on it for a little while. And then he said, hey, I'm bringing this friend of mine to lunch with us. And I went, great, no problem. And we all sat around and we had the show, the two of us, but this friend was there and he threw like one teeny little idea in, like, you should make the character's hat red. Oh, that's cool. Great. Guess what? For the rest of the existence of that show, the friend who went to lunch was suddenly part of the team and got a third of everything, was in every contract, was in every meeting, and was like, wow, I learned that one very quickly. I was like, can't do that again. So, yeah.
So you just have to be careful who gets put into a...
Because I want to say this too. Yeah. When you're working in Hollywood or in entertainment at all, if you're a creative person, you have a product. If you're an actor, you're the product. If you're pitching a cartoon idea, that's the product. Because it's called show what? Show business. It's what it's called. It's not called show play, show dancing or whatever. It's called show business. And so if you want to be serious about this and make a living doing what you love, you need to take it seriously. And then the book I wrote will help. And there's other books too. But I walk you through a lot of the steps I went through and some of the mistakes I made. So check it out if you can.
You know, experience does not have to be your best teacher. You can learn from someone else's mistakes.
That's right. Yeah. So learn from my mistakes.
It can save you some time.
Seeking wisdom right there. That's seeking wisdom, right? That's
amen. No, yeah. Absolutely.
Julie, I want to ask you, how do you and Butch work together? What's your guys' working arrangement? I mean, I see you're very smart, you're very intelligent, you're in there. It doesn't seem like anybody can push anything over in on you because you're savvy. So how do you and your husband work together?
Well, I'm his biggest fan, so I'm always protecting him. And so, you know, Butch he's so much into the creative part, and I've always been on the business side of things, and so that's how we really integrate really well. Like, for instance, when we've created a show, like we've got a children's show right now it's not cartoons, it's live action,
and it's not out there yet. We're still working on it.
It's amazing, but anyway, you know, it's like the writing part of it, that's not me. Like I'm not even going to go in there. You know, when he's in the studio directing, it's not my place either. Everything else, yes, you know, to make sure that, you know, schedules are on time and production,
paying,
all
paying
that stuff,
people,
contracts and
all
that.
This other stuff.
So right. When you know your lane, when you know where you should be, you know, it's like women, sometimes we tend to try to micromanage our husbands with everything.
No, no, never. That would never happen. That would never.
But when you do that, and especially with someone that's super creative, what I love is when he's around his own kind, you're like, my God, he is just a kid. Like he really is in his heart.
Yeah.
You know, but I think that's why we integrate so well. And you know, the main thing is that we both love Jesus, and we would not have a marriage today if we did not have Jesus Christ in our life.
No, Christ is definitely the cornerstone and the center of our life. You talked about the three stranded cord.
Yeah.
It's her and I and Christ right in the center. And you know, could we have done things in Hollywood without Christ? Absolutely. People do it all the time. But we feel we do it better with Christ because he's taken us places that we could never have found on our own. And I'm dead serious about that. And you know, there's ideas I've gotten that I never would have gotten before. There's connections I've gotten that I wouldn't have. But also he's just shown us how to involve people and involve ourselves in projects we never would have thought about on our own. And that's what I love.
You know, it's interesting too, because this is years ago. We would always get this phone call from his agent, you know, well, you know, that production company said, we don't know why we're doing this contract. We've never done it like this for anybody else, but we're going to do it for Butch. Mm-hmm. Those kind of things, we know that was God opening up doors and,
favor.
You know, and we just know favor. It. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I love it.
Many times that conversation would happen.
You know, Proverbs 3:5 says, trust in the Lord with all your heart, lean not on your own understanding. So my understanding is very limited. I have zero understanding, but there's things that happen in my career and things that are continuing to happen in my career that, you know, you're like, well, Lord, let's see. And listen, this isn't us taking our hands off the wheel like this. That's not what it's all about. You know, Deuteronomy says in chapter 8:18 says, I give you the power to get wealth. I don't give you the wealth. I give you the power to get it. So we all have, all of us, everybody watching has the power to get it. Where do you get it? And I have another question for people. Who are you listening to? I ask everybody out there, who are you listening to today? Are you listening to yourself? Are you listening to your best friend, your mom, your dad, Jesus? I mean, who are you listening to?